Let's take a closer look at this year's Monaco Grand Prix and what teams bring to the track. If you want to know more details about the special Monaco setup, check out my other video in the description. Since speeds in Monaco are relatively low, drag is not a big issue and teams try to increase downforce, even if that reduces their aero efficiency. This is called dirty downforce. And this is what we can see this year as well. Most teams bring the open flap tip because it allows them to use a straighter flap across the span and to use the rag box to its full extent. The tips are relatively straight, which creates a strong pressure difference, which results in tip vortices and hence induced drag. But it increases downforce, so teams do it. Another point is that teams use a trailing edge which is as straight as possible. The DRS pod is disturbing the flow in the center to a certain degree, which lets the flow separate earlier in the center. Teams usually reduce the chord of the flap in the center to cut the separated area off and to increase efficiency of the wing. In Monaco, we can see that Ferrari uses a straight trailing edge, McLaren has a small dip, and Red Bull a bigger cutout. And Red Bull has a strongly cambered tip, almost like a shovel, to guide even more air up. Teams also use larger gurney flaps and sometimes even more than 90 degree angle for them, also because the larger gurneys need to stay within the rag box. This slows the flow on top of the wing down even more, which means higher pressure and hence more downforce. At Mercedes, we can see that they are using a large open tip with their curled around transition, which they introduced last race. So they try to use more side expansion for more flow velocity underneath the wing and hence more downforce. Also, Mercedes uses the straight trailing edge and they have a strongly cambered profile in the center. In Monaco, it's all about the qualifying performance, so let me know who's your favorite this weekend. See you at the next video.